As Christians, we know that God knit meaning and purpose into our lives when He formed relationships with us through Christ. Our service in society is a response to Christ's love and a result of His Spirit living in and through us. As Christians, we know that we have a loving Heavenly Father who provides for all of us, and God uses us to provide for our neighbor. We become part of His divine providence, and He works through us in all that we do. The responsibility that we have in the fight against malaria isn't a burden, but a responsibility. We have the ability to respond to Christ's love because He has given us His Spirit. 1 John 4:14 says, "And we have seen and testify that the Father has sent His Son to be the Savior of the world." Through the Lutheran Malaria Initiative, God calls everyone on the campus of Concordia University not only to become part of His divine providence of physical healing in Africa, but also to testify His spiritual healing.
Anyone in the world could fork over $10 and say, "Here, buy yourself a bed net." In fact, if every student at Concordia gave $10, then we would only be $400 short from our $25,000 goal. But that wouldn't be the point.
The point is that our God is a God of relationships. He sent His Son to die so that He could restore His relationship with us, as His children and His witnesses on earth. That restored relationship with Him makes relationships with others possible. As the daughter of missionaries, I've grown up observing the relationships between those supporting, with those doing the service, with those being served, and I know that every person in this process is blessed. When God is involved, this isn't mindless good works, this is worship. On this campus, we're reminded daily that whatever we eat or drink, or whatever we do, whether that be studying for a test or walking with a friend, everything is done for the glory of God.
If we are a people who live responsibly to God's love in these little things in our daily lives, how much more will an already globally attentive campus be willing to push their energy and their worship and their love for God into this effort to stop malaria in Africa? How much more will we want to be witnesses to others of a God who forgives all of our sins and heals all of our diseases?